फ्रेंड्स व्हाट्सएप वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल दिस इज साई चरण मलयाला।
सो आई नो मेनी पीपल आर वेटिंग फॉर दिस वीडियो टीएसएम सेट काउंसलिंग प्रोसेस बाय साई चरण मलयाला। सो इट इज अ नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ पेमेंट ऑफ प्रोसेसिंग फीस स्लॉट बुकिंग सर्टिफिकेट वेरिफिकेशन एंड ऑप्शन एक्सरसाइज फॉर वेब बेस्ड काउंसलिंग फॉर टीएसएम सेट 2020 एमपीसी स्ट्रीम। Who can apply? Candidates who had qualified in TSM set and who secured 45% for OC and 40% for others in group subjects of intermediate or its equivalent examination can only apply for this web-based counseling. So first you have to download TSM set 2020 rank card from the TSAHE website, then go for counseling. In counseling there will be two phases, first phase and the final phase. Now I am going to explain the step-by-step process in first phase and when will be final phase conduct, who can apply and who can participate in final phase will be discussed in this video. This is the first phase schedule and first one from 9th to 17th you need to online fill the basic information, payment of processing fee and the slot booking for selection of helpline center, date and time to attend for certificate verification should be done in between 9th to 17th October. Then certificate verification for already slot booked candidates and certificate verification will be started from 12th and it will be ending on 18th October. Then exercising of options after certificate verification. After certificate verification you can you can go for web counseling where you need to give the options which of the colleges which you need to participate in the counseling and it will be from 12th to 20th October. I will explain the process how to give the options and everything will be shown in this video, so please stay tuned. Freezing of options 20th October, then provisional seat allotments of seats will be on 22nd October. On 22nd October you will be allotted the seats and the payment of tuition fee and self-reporting through website will be from 22nd to 27th of this month October. So this is done and this is done. I will explain in detail as we move forward in this video. So here is the payment of processing fee and this is the website where you need to go and pay your processing fee, tsmset.nic.in, and click on the link for payment of processing fee. Register by entering registration number given on TSM set 2020 hall ticket, date of birth as mentioned in SSC marks memo, hall ticket number of intermediate or its equivalent. Then this is the fee you need to pay for SC candidate students. They need to pay 600 for processing fee and 1200 for all others as a processing fee for this web counseling of TSM set. Then slot booking. So all categories candidates book your slot to attend certificate verification at the nearest convenient help center, means mentioned in annexure 1. I will show you the help centers now within the scheduled dates. Means when if you book the slot on 14th you need to go on 14th, and if you book the slot in the morning session you need to go at that time only. Then you can check it here, SG Government Polytechnic Adilabad and District Adilabad. Number of days of certificate verification is 3 and dates are from here 12 to 14. And categories of students who can attend are OC, BC, SC, ST, minorities. And Government Polytechnic, Bellampalli and District Manchirial. Like this, Government Polytechnic, Nirmal. You can check, just pause the video and check wherever, in which district and in which city, which is near to your house. You can select that and you can go anywhere according to your possibility. So these are all the, you can also take a screenshot of this so that you will be having an idea of where or the helpline centers. Then total 36 helpline centers are given. So these are the slot bookings: morning 9 to 9:30, 9:30 to 10, 10 to 10:30, 10:30 to 11, 11 to 11:30, and 11:30 to 12, 12 to 12:30, 12:30 to 1, and 1 to 2 is a lunch break, and 2 to 2:30 you can book according to your convenience and then attend for the certificate verification. And documents required for verification are TSM set rank card, TSM set hall ticket, Aadhaar card, SSC or its equivalent marks memo, and intermediate or its equivalent memo come pass certificate, and 6th to intermediate or its equivalent study certificates, which we call bona fide certificates, and transfer certificate TC, income certificate issued after January 1st of 2020, caste certificate if issued by competent authority if applicable, residence certificate of a candidate for a period of 7 years preceding to qualifying the examination in case where the candidate has no institutionalized education. So certificates to be produced by candidate at the verification hour, all original certificates and one set of Xerox copy. And I already explained all these things. And in respect to non-local candidates, in order to consider them for allotment under unreserved seat for the following certificates, you need to provide, means non-local candidates should provide residence certificate and employer certificate of his father or mother, so that you can proceed in the web counseling process. Physically handicapped and children of armed forces personnel can give the required certificates, like NCC also can provide the certificates. Sports, minority, Anglo-Indian candidates can provide the extra certificates too. Then certificate verification. Candidate presence is mandatory. Means you can say that, bro, as it is a corona time, I am not unable to go. My father will be going and completing the whole procedure of certificate verification. Is it possible? So what I say is, they clearly mentioned that physically a candidate should be present in the helpline center. So you need to attend at any cost for the certificate verification physically. So no entry for the candidates without mask. Candidates must maintain social distancing, and the body temperature of candidate will be checked using thermal scanner before entering to the helpline center. So these are all the precautions they are going to take while certificate verification. So okay, now certificate verification is done. So what next? Let's see. After certificate verification, you will be getting a login ID to the registered mobile number. Candidates registered mobile number. All the messages or OTPs allotment details will be sent to registered mobile number. Hence, advised to keep the mobile with you till the end of the admission process. So please be aware of this, that whatever the mobile number you are given during the registration of TSMSET, you need to keep it with you till the end of the admission process, and generate the password by clicking on candidate's registration link in the website, and don't share this password with anyone. Okay, like this there will be an interface here. You can give you the order of the choices according to your preferences. So civil, CSE, ECE, triple E, and infrastructure, and this is mechanical. So these are the college course. Like that, you need to select the college course and district you need to select here, and you have to give your choices, means you have to give the choice numbering according to your preference here, so that finally they will be coming into your one order. Then after that, you need to enter the one-time password. If you enter the OTP, the choices will be saved, and then you can log out of the interface. So this is the exercising options after certificate verification. So that you can do till 20th of this October, from 12th to 20th October. So you can ask one question, that brother, can we change the options once we have chose? That means you can change it any number of times till 20th October only. After 20th October, the freezing of options will be on 20th October. Freezing of options will be on 20th October. And the result of this first phase of counseling will be on 22nd October. You will be getting the allotted seat results. And on 22nd October, you will be getting the message to your mobile number, registered mobile number, regarding that, like you have been allotted seat in this particular college, and this is your choice number. Like that, it will be showing in your registered mobile message. Then after getting the seat, means after 22nd October, from 22nd to 27th October, you need to pay the payment of tuition fee and self-reporting through website. You need to do self-reporting through the website. The provisional first phase allotment of seats will be made on 22nd and will be placed in the website. So those who didn't got message, you can also check it through tsmset.nic.ac.in. So as I already said, okay, you can download the provisional allotment letter, enter the ROC form number, TSMSET hall ticket number, and password and date of birth, and login TSMSET. Okay, then pay the tuition fee in the provisional allotment order through online with the prescribed time, self-reporting through the online system in candidates login, and take admission under admission number to confirm the provisionally allotted seat, and take a printout. After self-reporting, you need to take the printout of that form. So the candidates who are satisfied with the previous allotment, means you are okay with the option which you got, means you are okay with the seat which you have got in the counseling, paid the tuition fee through the online and self-reported through website, need not to exercise options once again. However, they have to report the allotted college, means you need to physically report at the allotted college in between 2nd November to 5th November and register with the biometric for attendance at the college. So then after that, after the first phase, you will be having final phase. Means you will be having a doubt, who can access the options, means who can participate in final phase. Candidates who have secured seat but not interested to join, and who have not secured seat so far but got their certificates verified can also participate. Who have not went through web options so far but got their certificates verified, so they also can participate. And who have secured a seat, self-reported and aspiring for a better option, means looking for a better option than the allotted institute, and any other eligible candidates can apply for final phase of counseling of TSMCET. So then this is the schedule for final phase of TSMCET. Online filling, basic information, this will be till 29th October, and certificate verification for already slot booked candidates in the final phase. Here also same thing, you can also book the slots and pay the fee, and those who not verified earlier can verify now also. That will be on 30th October, and exercising of options means choosing the options will be from 30 to 31st October. Then freezing of options will be means after choosing till 31st you can choose, then on 31st the options will be freezed. And the provisional allotment seats means this is called special round and spot round. So this final phase allotment will be on November 2nd. After November 2nd, payment of tuition fee, self-reporting through website and reporting at the allotted college. You need to report at the allotted college in the final phase from 2nd November to 5th November. And in this during these days only, after allotting the seats on 2nd November, you need to pay the tuition fee and self-report through the website, and then reporting at the allotted college should be done. If not, your seat will be cancelled. So thank you one and all, and I request every one of you to share my channel, and you can see how much of productive work I am doing, and I request each and every one of you to share the videos to your friends and the family members who really need this information during the counseling. So thank you, and signing off, Sai Charan Malayala.
If you like the content of my channel, please like, share and subscribe. See you in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye bye.